Disaster relief is hard. Physically, emotionally, mentally. Physically, you do work. There's so much to be done. And you jump in and you do it. If it's pulling hundreds of pounds of frozen chicken from a freezer truck to thaw to feed 1,300 people on a Sunday afternoon, if it's cutting every last branch off of a fallen oak and dragging away the branches in 105 degree heat, if it's trying to sleep on an air mattress when your shoulders ache and your heart hurts. Emotionally, this work drains you. You stand in awe of the power of nature and it humbles you. Mentally, it's chaos. In a disaster area, lives are wrecked, and yet the victims are trying so hard to coordinate volunteers. The few that are there blame fear, blame comfort, and this is a disaster. How that affects you mentally is shocking. As we drove to the mile end of a dirt road to clear the path to a family's front porch, disaster relief is rewarding in all the same ways, physically, emotionally, mentally. You see, hard work rewards the recipient, and serving rewards you. People, do something. Turn off the news. Because in a disaster area, there's no other news. There's no worry about what's going on outside the hurt. And yet the sun rises each day. Hope begins anew. And when one person wears down, there needs to be someone to fill in. We choose the harder thing. God makes the way if we commit to clearing the path. And then, together, we light the way.